Let's get into ChatGPT. Now, if you've been active in tech Twitter, YouTube, or online, you've probably heard of ChatGPT. Now, let's separate the chat from the GPT. Now, GPT is a type of artificial intelligence model that OpenAI developed. You've also seen logos of OpenAI. It's actually a research laboratory based in San Francisco, California. Now, ChatGPT is a variant of GPT that's designed explicitly for conversational text. Now, I will go through a few questions you can ask ChatGPT. Then I'll show a code example of how to access the OpenAI API using Java. Here is a simple, quick question that is based on, is Java a good language to learn? I will get a short answer, which is pretty fancy. But this is just a simple question. Let's go to more advanced questions. Now, we have a question where the answer requires code samples. For example, like in the case of Java 11 HTTP client, it actually gives code samples to, you know, support its response. Now, let's even be more specific. We can go and be more specific about the type of code we want. For example, let's say we want a Spring REST API that greets a person with a name, a very simple REST API. It tells you the requirements and dependencies, explains the code. It tells you how to actually test the API and what response to expect. That is pretty lovely and organized. Now, this is a more specialized response than the other questions I have asked. But that's only part. We can go even deeper. Take a look at this code. Fellow Java devs, do you notice anything wrong with it? There are a few issues here, but can you detect them? Of course, I know you can. Now, this is just a simple example, but let's test the ChatGPT. I'll copy this code and I'll ask it to help me check what is wrong with my code. My code is giving me an issue. What is wrong with it? Now, you can see that it lists the errors in the code. And doesn't just do that, it suggests a correct version of what the code could be. Now, a cool thing about ChatGPT is that it can maintain context and remember previous conversations. That means it can hold a conversation with you rather than just providing one-off responses to individual questions. Now, let me demonstrate that. I will continue the conversation and ask it to provide a code that prints bonjour instead of hello. Now, it knows that we just spoke about a particular code it corrected. It is actually going to edit the code and make it print bonjour instead of hello. I think that is amazing. Now, into the developer parts. This is where the men come in. Now, OpenAI API allows developers to access and use their machine learning models in their own applications. Using the OpenAI API is straightforward. You need to sign up for an API key, choose the model you want to use, and make a request to the API with your input data. Now, the API will return the model outputs which you can use in your application. I have been saying model and model. So what is a model? A model is a pre-trained machine learning system that can perform a specific task. For example, there are models designed to translate text from one language to another, or there are models capable of generating realistic images of objects or people. Now, different models are available through the OpenAI API, covering many tasks and capabilities. Now, there are many different models available through the OpenAI API, and they cover many tasks and capabilities. Some examples of models are language translation, you have image generation, text generation, and more. So each model has a specific ability and suited for a certain task. So you have to be sure of, you know, what task you want. There are existing libraries that can be used to work with the API, and we're going to use the Java library. Now, check your API keys, and if you don't have one, you can generate one because we're going to use it in our Java code. I will share the GitHub link to the library, and you can of course go through the description. It's quite straightforward, and I will also share my code that I use in this lesson. Now, I created a Gradle project because we're going to use some dependencies. I'll import the OpenAI API Java library. I use retrofit as well. So there are different endpoints, as you can later check in the documentation. For now, we will use the edit endpoint. The edit endpoint can be used to edit text. So you give it some text and then instruction on how to modify the text. Don't worry, I'll show you an example. Now, the model we're going to use is the text DaVinci Edit 001. Yeah, that's a long, funny name for a model. Now, the model used here, the text DaVinci, is designed to generate text similar to the given prompt, but with some edits. For example, you could use the model to generate a text similar to a given prompt, but with some words replaced or inserted, as I will demonstrate here. The input is the input text that is supposed to be edited. And then the instruction is the instruction that tells the model how to edit the prompt. Now, in our code, I have our text, which is I like program in Java. How about you? So this is a text that obviously has, you know, grammar and spelling mistakes. So I want the API to help me correct it, and we will see the response. Now, when we run it, we see the first response, which is, "Hi Jack, I like programming in Java. How about you?" So that's one way that it thinks it can be corrected, but I'll run it again and see if I find another version. And we see the second version. "I'm Jack. I like programming in Java. How about you?" So I think this second version is acceptable. Of course, there are other options you can use to tweak the potential response to be more like what you want. This is just a simple example of how to use the API, and you can see that it actually tried. I gave it a text that I felt was faulty, and it responded with a correction on the spelling and grammar. So that is ChatGPT for you. You can either just use the chats on the OpenAI website for your researches, or you can use the API in your programs for more beautiful operations.